Ladies and gentlemen, this is Intervlog. I say this is Intervlog, and I am here once more. I am here because there is one important information I have for you, and this information is unbelievable. I say it is unbelievable. Why? Because we have never imagined that things would change so soon. If anybody had told us 3 years ago that both America and France will not be in Niger, Burkina Faso, and Mali, we would never have believed it. But now, it has happened. American soldiers have left both Niger, Burkina Faso, and Mali, and they may leave many, many more countries in Africa based on the way things are going. But the one that is surprising everybody right now is what Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov said. He said that Russia will be sending more military instructors to Burkina Faso. What does this mean? Since 1 year ago, Russia has been supporting Burkina Faso, both militarily and economically. Since France left Burkina Faso, there is no country in Africa that has received ammunition, war equipment, like Burkina Faso. Sometimes we wonder who is going to manipulate all these war weapons because they are sophisticated weapons. We are talking about the highest level of war armament. But as we were still wondering, Lavrov, the Russian foreign minister, came out to say that they are going to send military instructors to Burkina Faso. Therefore, nobody should panic about who is going to fly those new jet flights, who is going to control the drones, who is going to drive the tanks, and so on and so forth. Why? Because Russia is going to send a SPAT. Russia will increase the number of military instructors in Burkina Faso, Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov said on Wednesday during a trip to the West African nation. Russian instructors are working here, and their number will increase. At the same time, we are training members of the armed forces and law enforcement agencies of Burkina Faso in the Russian Federation, Lavrov said in the capital city of Ouagadougou. Here, Russian instructors are working. Their number will increase. Russia furthermore intends to supply Burkina Faso with military products to strengthen the country's defense capability, he said. Russia's foreign ministry on Wednesday posted a photo of Lavrov in Ouagadougou, noting that he had been received by President Ibrahim Traoré. Lavrov was accompanied on the trip by Russian Deputy Defense Minister Yevkurov. If you check from the time Russia began to send ammunitions and the support to Burkina Faso till today, you will find out there will be over 1,000 ammunitions, military equipment, tanks, helicopters, everywhere. Therefore, Russia is going to send more than 1,000 military instructors in order to teach Burkina Faso how to use these ammunitions. And Russia have so many military instructors. Therefore, we will be expecting a lot of Russians now, based on what you see, and this brought me to what I have always said. I have always said that good governance is everything. Imagine if Ibrahim Traoré is not a good leader. Do you think Russia will be helping Ibrahim Traoré? The answer is no. Do you think if Ibrahim Traoré is mismanaging the economy of Burkina Faso? Do you think Russia will be sending her military instructors to help somebody who is mismanaging his country's economy? The answer is no. Do you think if Ibrahim Traoré has been approving Toyota SUV for every governor, every minister, every senator, every lawmaker, every local government chairman, do you think Russia will have that willing to help Burkina Faso? Do you think that if Ibrahim Traoré has had 15 Toyota SUV, new one, escort him everywhere he goes, which each one cost $200,000, if he had done that, do you think Russia will have that mind to help Ibrahim Traoré? The answer is no. That is the reason I always complain. Good behavior draws good relationship. A good president attracts support, where a corrupt president will attract a disaster. If you're corrupt, your friend will be corrupt. No good person will come to help you because they know you are corrupt. No good leader will be your friend. Just check all these old dictators who have ruled Africa. How many friends do they have? Nothing. The only friend they have is that Toyota SUV they are approving. Cars have become their friends. All these countries that are approving Toyota SUV every for 4 years, for their lawmakers, for the president, for the ministers, for the governor. Now check how the country is or how the countries are. They are poor countries. Look at their friends. All their friends are the friends that come to suck their economy down. Look at Ibrahim Traoré, a very, very young president who has not even been to the office up to 3 years. See the support he is getting from Russia, from everywhere. Why? Because they know he is doing his best. Do you think it is easy for a country to send about 1,000 military instructors to your country? But by seeing what he is doing, Russia has determined to help Burkina Faso in absence of US and France in Burkina Faso. Therefore, if you see any leader who comes to lead you, and the first thing he will do is to approve Toyota SUV for senators, for governors, for lawmakers, for local government chairmen, that leader is not a good leader for your country. A good leader should think about production, manufacturing, good governance, and progress of your country. If he is a good leader, he would have used that money that he is spending on buying Toyota Land Cruiser SUV to build factories and employ people and send people to work. There is no work in Africa. There is no money in Africa. In Africa, everybody is running everywhere. Some of Africans are fleeing to Europe. Why? Because there is lack of employment, and a leader will be elected. The little money he has, instead of to use it to create the employment, he will use it to buy Toyota SUV. And he's not buying only one, not two. So he's buying up to 1,000 pieces. This Toyota SUV, didn't he know that the money that he is spending on this Toyota could be enough even to buy tractors and to send everybody to farm? Therefore, if you see any leader who is approving Toyota SUV instead of buying tractors, building factories, that leader is not a good leader. Why didn't they use it to build factory? Because they are bad leaders. They are the ones that is bringing Africa economies down. And look at their friends. Their friends never taught them about good governance. Why? Because some of their friends are also coming to bring Africa down more. Thank you very much for watching. This is Intervlog.